Join us on a journey to explore China's rapidly advancing space program, with a budget of $5 billion annually. From reusable spacecraft to land on the moon's far side, China's space exploration achievements will leave you amazed. Discover China's progress and potential in space exploration as we uncover the secrets of China's space program. Hello everyone, and welcome to the channel. Remember to subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon to ensure you get all the updates. The Chinese government allocates over $5 billion in annual funding to its space exploration program, which has made tremendous advancements in recent years. The China National Space Administration, CNSA, the country's space agency, has accomplished a great deal in various fields, including launching satellites into space, transporting humans into space, and exploring the moon. In 2003, China successfully sent a human into space, making it the third country in the world to accomplish this feat. Since then, the nation has completed several crewed space missions, one of which involved the installation of a space station in orbit that is permanently staffed. Tiangong 1, China's first experimental space station, was launched in 2016. The launches of Tiangong 2 followed this in 2016 and Tiangong 3 in 2022. China's first space station was dubbed Tiangong 1. These space stations have been used for a wide range of scientific investigations and experiments, including microgravity and the practice of space medicine. The Tiangong 3 space station is the newest and most technologically advanced space station that China has built to date. It got off the ground in 2022, but now it's widely regarded as the nation's most crucial space mission. The Tiangong 3 space station surpasses its predecessors, the Tiangong 1 and Tiangong 2 space stations, in size and technological prowess. It is outfitted with cutting-edge life support systems, scientific research facilities, and a robotic arm to accommodate a crew of up to 6 astronauts for extended periods while in orbit. Additionally, it is meant to accommodate up to 6 astronauts. Several scientific instruments and experiments can be carried out on the Tiangong 3 space station. These include a high-resolution spectrometer, a space telescope, and a space-based laser communication system. In addition to being utilized for research in subjects such as space medicine, biology, and material science, these devices are used to analyze the planet Earth, the solar system, and the universe. The Tiangong 3 space station is also being utilized to develop new technologies and perform experiments in various fields, including removing space trash, provisioning in-orbit servicing, and generating solar power in space. The successful launch of China's Tiangong 3 space station is a significant accomplishment for the country's space program and a clear indication of China's expanding capabilities in space technology and exploration. In the future, China's goals for space-based scientific research and the exploration of deep space both stand to benefit significantly from its implementation of this technology. Exploration of the moon is another area where China's space program has achieved considerable advancements in recent years. In 2019, the Canadian Space Agency, CSA, successfully became the first nation to land a rover on the moon's dark side. This accomplishment places Canada in an entire company. Since then, the rover, which has been given the name Chang'e 4, has conducted various scientific studies. These have included the examination of the lunar geology and the collection of samples of the lunar soil. In the year 2020, the China National Space Administration, CNSA, successfully landed a lunar explorer by the name of Chang'e 5 on the near side of the moon. Chang'e 5 collected surface samples from the moon and then returned to Earth during its mission. The Chang'e 5 mission is a lunar exploration mission scheduled to take place in 2020 and will be carried out by the China National Space Administration, CNSA. China accomplished this feat for the first time, successfully retrieving lunar samples from the surface of the moon. The Chang'e 5 spacecraft safely landed on the moon's near side on December 1, 2020, after being launched on November 24, 2020. The spaceship had 4 modules, an orbiter, a lander, an ascender, and a returner. After touching down on the moon's surface, the lander used its ascender to transport 2 kilograms of lunar rock and soil samples back to the orbiter. The orbiter subsequently transmitted the materials back to Earth. This mission was a remarkable accomplishment for China's space program and represented a big step forward in exploring the moon's surface. Additionally, it demonstrated China's developing skills in space technology, including the capability to land and operate a spacecraft on the moon's surface, collect samples from another celestial body, and bring them back to Earth. The samples that Chang'e 5 obtained have been used in scientific research in geology, mineralogy, and geochemistry. These studies have resulted in new understandings of the birth and development of the Moon. The fact that China was able to complete the Chang'e 5 mission has not only established the nation as a significant player in the international community of lunar exploration. Still, it has also paved the way for China to complete future lunar missions and efforts to explore deep space. The rise in the number of satellites China has launched is another indication of the country's progress in space technology. In 2019, China was the enormous satellite launcher globally, having successfully deployed 35 satellites into orbit. These satellites are used for various tasks, including communication, navigation, and monitoring Earth's environment. In 2019, China was the enormous satellite launcher globally, having successfully deployed 35 satellites into orbit. The China National Space Administration, CNSA, and the China Aerospace Science and Technology Corporation, CASC, were responsible for the launches of these satellites, which served various functions, including communication, navigation, and Earth observation, when deployed into orbit. The vast majority of satellites successfully launched in 2019 were designed for commercial and civilian applications such as remote sensing, navigation, and communications. Famous satellites found that year include the Beidou 3 navigation satellites, part of China's global navigation system, GNSS, that competed with GPS and Galileo. These spacecraft were among the most notable satellites launched that year. In addition, China launched several Earth observation satellites, which will be utilized for environmental monitoring, the mapping of natural resource distribution, and disaster management. These satellites are outfitted with high-resolution cameras and other cutting-edge sensors, allowing them to acquire images and data with a degree of precision and clarity that is unparalleled in the industry. The growing number of satellites launched by China reflects the country's growing capabilities in space technology and the importance of satellite-based technology in various fields, including communication, navigation, and environmental monitoring. This is evidenced by China's increasing number of satellite launches. China is quickly becoming a key player in the global satellite business. Due to this growing number of launches, it is positioned to play an essential role in determining the direction that satellite technology will go in the future. In addition to these accomplishments, China has created various cutting-edge technology for space exploration, such as reusable spacecraft, and is preparing for future expeditions to Mars. Because it enables missions to be carried out in a manner that is both more effective and less costly, the reusable spacecraft technology that China has developed represents a significant advancement in the country's attempts to explore space. The ability of reusable spacecraft to undergo repeated launches results in a reduction in the overall cost of each mission and an increase in the number of times that tasks are carried out. In addition, China has disclosed its intentions to send astronauts to Mars in the not-too-distant future, with one of these missions designed to bring back samples. The mission's objective is to gather samples from the surface of Mars and get them back to Earth for analysis. These samples are expected to yield significant insights into the planet's geology, mineralogy, and potential habitability. In addition, the government of China has declared its intention to establish a manned outpost on Mars, which would also function as a research station for scientists who wish to investigate the planet. The ambitious goals that China has set for itself in terms of space exploration and its resolve to become a significant player in the international space industry are reflected in these programs. China's space program is a source of pride for the country and its people, and it will continue to push the boundaries of what is possible in space technology and exploration. We hope you have enjoyed learning more about China's space exploration program and its progress and potential. This is it, everyone. So, what do you think? Leave a comment and let us know. Thank you for watching the video. Remember to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you still need to. Also, put on the notifications because the following video is going to be a great one.